I've been working on a presentation for the company I work for and have finished a slide about our class. I'm ready to add a chart on slide 4 now. In PowerPoint, you have the ability to create various types of charts. A chart is a useful tool that you can use to communicate numeric information in a concise and often easy-to-read format. For example, you could create a chart illustrating the sales revenue per region or the sales total per salesperson. As we practice creating charts in PowerPoint, you'll see how many types of charts there are and the kind of information you can use them for to communicate. On this slide, I want to insert a chart that shows our demographics on who took classes at our center last year. There are two ways to insert a chart. If your slide layout has a placeholder like this, you can just click the Insert Chart command. Or you can select the Insert tab on the ribbon and then click the Insert Chart command. The Insert Chart dialog box appears. You can see that we have some common chart types such as column, line, pie, and bar charts, and some other chart options such as area, donuts, and radar charts. You can scroll up and down to see all the charts, or click the labels on the left to move through the options. Certain charts work better for certain types of data. As you work with charts, you'll learn more about this. I think a column chart will work, and I like this 3D one. Just click it to select it, and then click OK. This opens Excel and shows PowerPoint on one side and Excel on the other. The data you see in the Excel spreadsheet is the data used for the PowerPoint chart. This is called source data. Don't worry, this is default or placeholder data that you are expected to change. Okay, now that we've inserted the charts, I'm ready to add my own data. Instead of series 1, I'll put women. Then I'll press the tab key to move to the next cell. As I do this, the new data appears in the PowerPoint chart to the right. I'll go ahead and enter my next heading. Now, I don't need this column with series 3, but this blue line here represents the data range that is used in the chart. To increase or decrease this, we just need to click and drag the lower right corner of the range, like the instructions recommend. And now, series 3 is not included in the data range for the chart. Now just click and drag to select the cells. Release the mouse button and press the delete key on the keyboard. Okay, the other labels are age ranges, and I'll just enter those in the Excel spreadsheet. Under 18, 18 to 30, then 31 to 50, 51 to 65, and the last one, over 65. Now I just need to click and drag the range so the last one is included. And our new data appears in the chart. Now all I need to do is add our data from last year. I'm actually going to paste this information from another spreadsheet to save some time. We're done with Excel, so let's go ahead and close the spreadsheet without saving it. You can see the data from the Excel spreadsheet in our PowerPoint chart. When we inserted the chart, three new tabs appeared on the ribbon. These contain various chart tools and commands that you can use to modify your chart. Let's take a look at a few. From the Design tab, we can change the chart type. Just click the command and the Insert Chart dialog box will appear. Now, just choose another chart type. It can be a different column chart or another type altogether. I'll try this one. which will just change it slightly. If you ever need to edit the data, just click the Edit Data command and an Excel spreadsheet will open. From here, you can go ahead and edit the data. You can also change the chart style, which will give you some different color options. Click the More drop-down arrow to see all your options. Here, I like this one. I'll just click it to select it. And now my chart style has changed. In addition to chart styles, you can change the chart's layout. Basically, the chart layout just displays the information in various ways. For example, if I click this layout, my chart will have a chart title. Let's see, I'll try this one. This chart is nice because it has a chart title, a legend that identifies what each color represents, and labels for each axis. To enter text, just select the text box and type your text. On the x-axis, or horizontal axis, I'll just enter age ranges. Now, on the y-axis, which is often referred to as the vertical axis, I'll enter people served. I thought I wanted a chart title, but I don't really think I need one. I could choose another chart layout, or I can modify specific areas of the chart from the Layout tab. Let's select it and take a look. As you can see, there are a lot of commands available from this tab, way too many to tell you about. The ones you will use the most often are in the Labels group. You can click the Chart Titles command to remove a chart title or add a chart title. We'll select None to remove it. You can click the Axis Titles command and choose to hide or display the horizontal or x-axis. You can also hide the vertical or y-axis or choose to display the axis label horizontally or vertically. Right now, our legend is to the right of the chart, but if you click the Legend command, you'll see a menu with various locations you can move it. Just select an option to move the legend. Let's see. Let's move it above the chart. Now, click Data Labels and select Show to display all data labels above each column. The Axes group gives you some commands that control both axes and which grid lines are visible. And the Backgrounds group controls some visual aspects of the chart, such as whether the background of the chart or the chart's wall is gray or black, and the color of the chart's floor. You'll notice that the Analysis group is not active right now. Well, that's because we're working with a column chart. This group becomes active when you work with other charts, like line charts. Finally, the Format tab gives you some options to change the colors and overall look of the chart. This tab may look familiar if you've worked with tables or shapes before. From here, I may want to change the style of the box that surrounds the chart by selecting a shape style, or even format my axis labels with a word art style. Charts can be as simple or as complex as you like in PowerPoint. With 3 tabs of chart tools, including over 30 commands, plus layouts and styles, you'll have a lot of control over the chart you create.